Hello, everyone. I'm Conrad Fisher, Professor of Medicine, Residency Program Director in New York City. And here I am as a Residency Program Director to give you some tips on how to have a successful match and to make sure you show yourself off to your best possible advantage. First of all, what do you look like to a Program Director across the Eros application? You've spent so long to prepare, so long on the application, so long on doing USMLE and on your transcript. Now is the right time to make sure that you show yourself to your best advantage. So what does the program director sees? He sees your name, he sees your schools, he sees your scores, he'll see your picture. Now, the other things like the letters of recommendation have to be clicked through. They're not seen on the first screen. The personal statement has to be clicked through, in even your transcript. Has to be clicked through. Now, transcripts, particularly when two-thirds of U.S. schools are pass-fail in the first two years, don't help a whole lot, do they? When you have the majority of schools being pass-fail, and for international students, the transcripts have such variability. Some have traditional grades like A, B, C, D, E. Some have numerical. Some are out of scoring systems of 600. It's hard to know what to do with those transcripts, particularly across schools. Now, you might think it's obvious or silly, but the picture says something about you. Nice three-quarter view, how you doing? And make sure you get everything double-checked. Second tip is to make sure you take the maximum amount of time to study. If your scores are not due until September 15th, then why take your test in May? Well, I wanna have an easy summer, I wanna take some time off. Oh, well, yes, if you go unmatched, well, your schedule's going to free up. You'll have a lot of time off. Take the maximum time. This is a high-stakes exam. Don't stop 5 minutes too soon. Fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run and make sure that you squeeze out the last possible fragment of knowledge. So your 228 becomes a 230. Your 238 becomes a 240, and you'll hit those cutoffs. Next, practice your interviews. Make sure your appearance is right. And that's why people all tend to look the same. Why? I understand we all want to assert our individuality, me more than most, right? But you've got to also come to fit in with what the expectation is of an interviewer. Ask the right questions. Look attentive. And if people are late or don't pay right attention to you on the interview day, well, then you smile and go, "That's okay. Everything's fine," because flexibility is a sign of intelligence. Next, after you practice, make sure that you have applied broadly, because you don't want to say that you could have gotten an extra 2 or 3 interviews if you'd put out another 10 or 20 applications. Now is not the time to save a couple of dollars. Main thing is to be insecure, to get things double checked, and not in a weak way to say, "Did I get that right? There's nothing wrong with that. How about this? Is there anything else I should do differently next time?" Even the most perfect person can say, "I can always do something differently." This is Conrad Fisher, Professor of Medicine, Residency Program Director, and most importantly for you, the author of the Master the Board series of books and recordings, where all of my knowledge, experience, love, and depth has been concentrated in a single moment in time to make sure everything you need is contained in these devices. And we will not let you down. The Master of the Books, Master of the Wards books are a bright deed in a weary world. If you have any comments or questions, leave them below. We love hearing from our students and hope to see you on the interview trail, and wishing you great success.